If you want to start learning game dev in C++ with no engine, I promise you that you can start today, no matter if you are a beginner or advanced, no matter how low level you want to do it, and no matter how far you want to get, as long as you can pay attention to this video. Many people do the same mistake that I will help you to avoid. This channel is dedicated to exactly this topic, so I'll explain what are your steps and options, and then point you to the right tutorial for the job, so let's go! First of all, you need to have some basic experience with C++ to start game dev. So, let me put it this way. You should be able to implement a very simple game in the console. If not, watch this video first because there I will tell you how to properly start learning C++ for game dev, or just in general. Links to all of the resources in the description. Okay, so this is the roadmap that you need to follow when making a game. This makes sense, but you probably don't know any of these steps, so you need to learn them, and you might be tempted to, well, learn them in order, right? You can't build a game without having how to draw things on the screen. Well, here is the mistake that I see many people make. Taking things in order is not necessarily good, and you'll see exactly why in a second. So now, you have two options. You can either use a library that does these two steps for you, or you can go low level and code those steps yourself. Well, making a game in C++ from scratch is already low level for most people, but you and me are a little different. But even if you choose to make things yourself, I strongly recommend you to start with using a pre-made library, just to understand how things work. You need to understand what a game loop is, what delta time is, and other concepts before you can make a game. And here is why. Imagine you make everything yourself, and now you have a strange bug while making a game. Well, it can be because of any of these reasons, and that's hard to debug. But if you build your way up slowly, using pre-made libraries and focusing on this step first, and learning it well, there will be less failure points, and once you get to making things yourself, you are less likely to make errors here, because you already have experience. So, there are many libraries that you can use. Some of them are called SFML or Raylib, or even my game setup and 2D library for this. If you choose SFML or Raylib, I strongly recommend just finding a full tutorial online, so they can help you with the setup. This series, for example, I have found to be very informative. But if you choose to use my setup, I have a full game guide for it, that you should use. And one other important aspect about it, is that I already made the setup for you, so we can really focus on the game dev stuff. This setup part is very difficult and annoying in C++, so I made the setup extremely easy to start using. You just download it and it works. And this is very important because instead of spending days configuring libraries, you download it, you run it, and you can see something on the screen. This is not the same thing as using an engine. It is just learning things one step at a time, and you'll eventually learn to do everything yourself, if you want to. But trust me, it is better to do them in this order. So leave this setup stuff for later. And there is another reason to use this setup, but that's for the bonus tip. Okay, now that you know some basics about game dev, let's see how you can make this setup yourself. Now opening a window yourself is something that most people don't do, but you can learn that if you want. My WinAPI for Game Developer series actually teaches you exactly this, and you can also learn these things by watching the first videos of Handmade Hero series. But what if you want to draw things yourself? Well, for this you need to use a low-level graphics API, like OpenGL, Vulkan or DirectX. I will talk about OpenGL, and I think it is the best for beginners. Vulkan is the future instead, but it is very hard to learn if you don't know some other graphics API first. So just start with OpenGL. And not the old OpenGL, that's too irrelevant for today. So OpenGL allows you to tell the GPU to draw some things for you. And here, this step will be split in two, loading OpenGL and using it. But graphics APIs are very unforgiving. Any error can give you a black screen and a ton of places to debug. And there are many steps before you can render your first triangle on the screen. So I once again recommend you to either download my full game setup that uses OpenGL, or just download my lightweight OpenGL setup. This just opens OpenGL correctly, so you are sure that this step has no errors. And you can then learn your OpenGL programming. I'll learn to do this yourself later. I also configure error reporting in both setups, which is a thing that no one talks about. Basically, modern OpenGL can report errors to you very nicely, and with no extra steps except that you need to tell it to do so. So I'll do that for you in this setup. If you don't want to use it, you can find error reporting stuff here, in the debugging chapter on learnopengl.com. Other than that, I recommend you this playlist for learning OpenGL. It is the best playlist in my opinion, And of course, the Learn OpenGL.com website. And I also post interesting OpenGL content on this channel, so subscribe if you are interested in that. And finally, bonus tips. 1. You can find some very nice reading resources on my Discord. 2. Keep yourself motivated by showing others what you are doing, and also by watching what others are doing. You can do that on my Discord, for example, and there you can also ask for help. And 3. Always make systems to make your life easier. So I strongly recommend you using the imgui library to easily add widgets to your game for debugging. imgui is already configured in my setup, so once again, a reason to use it. Finally, if you are asking yourself if you can use my setup for making a finished game, well, you can totally do that if you want. I made a finished Steam game with it, so it is competent enough. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to share it and make sure you now go to the description to find the next video to watch, depending on your current level, to finally start game dev in C++.